I'm Julie Latofsky, here with Dr. David Schauer, continuing our video series on topics of interest to Kyrene teachers. In our last session, Dr. Schauer, we got to speak a little bit of an overview of the whole Kyrene blueprint.
Right.
And today we're going to hone in a little bit on specifically goal two, the compensation topic.
That's an important one.
Thank you for joining us again for this.
Thank you for doing this.
Goal two in the Kyrene blueprint states that to have the best and brightest, we'll set recruitment and retention of high quality staff as a priority, along with quality professional development and evaluation. These are familiar objectives, Dr. Schauer. Mm-hmm. So what is new this year in our efforts to achieve them?
You know, I would say as we look at the blueprint for Kyrene and see that you know, each goal has specific objectives, and then each objective has strategies, and each strategy has measurements. And so I think the thing that's different from what we've done in the past is now we're more focused on total compensation. And so as we think about how we compensate all of our employees, it's about everything, you know, that can be provided in terms of benefits and other things that go along, of course, with salary. You know, so the focus on total compensation, I think, is a little different, although it's been around for a while now for teachers, and other employee groups are now, you know, starting down that road. Then the other piece is really what we've been doing with the Gallup organization, you know, because we just had over 70% of our employees complete that survey. And so we're very interested in what our employees think about their working conditions, because that's a real big part of how people feel about what they do for a living.
Right.
So I think those two things will help us move beyond where we've been before.
Thank you. We have three specific compensation questions for you today, just topics that have been on teachers' minds.
Okay.
The first one was the issuance of amended contracts for education credits. In the past, teachers had until October 15th to submit paperwork for budgeted credits, and amended contracts were issued within
right.
a few weeks. And now, teachers file paperwork for completed credits by February 15th.
Mm-hmm.
And the budget is set by July 1st. It seems that amended contracts should be taken care of by then, but what happened this year is we went into October and well into October before those contracts came out.
Right.
Is there a way, do you foresee a way that we can fix this in the future?
I think we can. You know, one of the things, a bright spot, you know, that we have is that the governing board has been willing to fund the professional development.
Right.
And really that is the only way that teachers have been seeing any kind of increase in their base salary. And so what has changed about that with the system is we used to have maybe about 100 teachers that would apply by the deadline. Now we have over 400. And so I think what is happening in HR is it's just overload. And so what they're learning, and I think what we're all learning, is that we can streamline the work. The other thing is how it interfaces with meet and confer, because from what I understand, the meet and confer team still was unfinished, you know, by the end of the school year, and needed to come back in the fall and talk about professional growth and sort of agreeing to how that was going to, you know, play out. And I think we could fix that. You know, I think we could probably make those decisions sooner than later, so that the work could begin in HR sooner. You know, because you would think that with the entire summer to do that work, that it would be easier to get those out. You know,
that's good news. It seemed like something that we could address.
Mm-hmm.
More
I have confidence that we can make that better.
Good. Another the second question is about payroll decisions in general. Teachers have expressed concern through their KEA reps about the decision on career ladder payments, the decision how to pay balance of contracts in June. That's changed in the last few years. And even the decision of how we issue first paychecks when we return for a new school year and how that affects new hires or returning teachers.
Right.
There is uncertainty, I think, amongst teachers about how these decisions are made. What could we do to address some of those teacher concerns about compensation issues?
I think that you know, one thing we all need to be very cognizant of is that, you know, even though we haven't taken salary decreases in base salary, that our employees have been taking decreases because of, you know, increased contributions for health care, increased contributions for retirement, less money for performance pay, you know, that affect teachers. So I understand the sensitivity, you know, because any money that's either withheld and paid at a later date or whatever, it's affecting people, you know, on a every 2 weeks,
yeah,
you know,
definitely,
and so they're
yes.
worried, you know, about making ends meet. So I think there are ways to address any of these issues, and you know, through our representative groups, I think we can talk about, you know, how we schedule things, how we do things, making sure that we make the best decisions possible. You know, the career ladder decision, I know the concern, you know, was that if somehow that lawsuit prevailed and we lost the funding, that if we had to go back later and ask teachers to repay that money, you know, that would be just a horrible thing to be doing. While it, you know, it's certainly different than it was before, at least we know that that possibility won't happen, you know. So I, you know, answer in a nutshell is I think we can work on all of these things and, you know, find the very best way to handle them so that it has a positive impact, because we really want people to not be so stressed out, you know, and they are, you know.
That is true. I've
heard many stories, and it's not an easy time.
Well, you've already hit on what the third issue is, that the immediate issue for teachers is that the average net salaries have not increased or have in fact decreased in recent years.
Yeah.
With reductions in career ladder, performance pay, you hit on two more.
Right.
Even though those are pieces that in fact benefit us, the health care and the
Retirement,
but also the no base increases. What's next in the overall compensation picture for teachers? I guess I should also throw in with the decisions that we know are ahead of us in the Arizona legislature this coming year.
Yeah.
What's ahead for us?
Well, you know, we're doing a lot of speculation right now about what the legislature may do. You know, we hear catastrophic scenarios, which we have heard things like this before, so it's not that new. But we are trying to be proactive, you know, and so we're expecting some kinds of reductions. But we know that in our district, compensation is a priority. You know, so while no promises can be made, there's full understanding and sensitivity to the fact that our employees have had no raises for 2 years during very difficult economic times. It's something we really want to do, and we're going to do what we can to address that. But if we're facing cuts of anywhere between $10 and $15 million, you know, who knows what we might have to do. So, you know, I know that's not real hopeful, but it's written in the blueprint that compensation is a goal. You know, we really want to be known as the district that pays very well and that has the best working conditions for employees, and that's genuine. You know, so while it may not happen immediately, and we might be frustrated that, is, you know, we haven't seen a lot of progress in that area, it's definitely in the forefront.
And given that we are going to have to deal with all these extreme circumstances depending on the decisions of the legislature,
right.
That leads to what our next focus can be, that in our next conversation, if it is all right with you, we would like to move to that other aspect of teacher employment, which is working conditions.
Sure.
And start our talk about, in particular, some of the time issues that are impacting teachers.
Mm-hmm. I think that'd be a great conversation. And by then we'll have the Gallup results too. So we'll actually have something, you
that'll
know,
be
objective.
Valuable.
Yeah,
all right.
I think it will be.
Well, thank you. Appreciate your time.
Thank you very much.